It's your boy Mariko.
Million Mo Easy.
We're here with a special guest today.
Live, Love, Culture, Clothing Line. My good
man, Howie. Appreciate you guys for coming through, you know. So what's going on, man? Y'all all got the gear on, man. I see the gear. It's cool. How long y'all been operating this movement that y'all been doing?
We've been rocking since about 2011. Mm-hmm. Really started kicking off by like 2013.
So what does it represent? Live, love, culture. Like,
we just.
What's the idea behind that?
We just embracing unity and positivity through clothing. You know what I mean? Just trying to do it a whole different way.
How so?
By just giving something rare, man. You know what I'm saying? Like unique that fits you. You know what I mean? Your own personality. Mm-hmm. At the same time, we don't direct the clothes to just one culture of people, you know? Okay. I feel like if we live in love, we all in one unity, you know what I'm saying? No matter what your race is, so that's basically the base behind it.
Okay.
And we usually, you know, bring positive people, you know what I'm saying, that we know that we have personal connections with into the group, you know what I'm saying, into the crew, you know what I'm saying? So we don't really promote negative. You know what I'm saying? Negative vibes and all that negative energy. Like,
was y'all like teach friends or whatever before y'all even started getting the clothing, or y'all came together through clothing?
Yeah, we all
family. Grew up the same neighborhood, you know. Raised, all that's PG raised, you know, Atlanta.
Okay. Right, good influence, you know? Like, it's about, you know, looking at one starting it all, and then looking at the other, you know? It's like, it's just a movement. At the same time, like John started his clothes off, I seen what he was doing. You know, he made me, not made me, but made me feel like I needed to be a part of it. So I got the camera, you know.
And so
I
you the cameraman? It.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what do you do?
I'm the brand ambassador. Like, I expand the brand through social media, personal, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Connections. I try to put the brand in different stores, different outlets. I go to school in Baltimore, so now, you know, we setting up a fashion show at Coppin State, Morgan, you know what I'm saying? Just spreading that good energy out there, getting people aware to the brand, you know.
How about you?
I DJ, a little bit of graphic design.
Okay.
And I pretty much take care of all the music for the shows, you know, anything we need audio-wise.
So y'all doing a lot of shows, fashion shows and stuff like that?
Absolutely.
Where y'all mostly getting your shows? Like,
mostly colleges.
Okay.
Colleges. Some of the schools that y'all are very tight with so far.
Morgan.
Coppin.
We did a joint pretty boy a long time ago.
Yeah.
Mostly in the DMV.
We got some things upcoming. Yeah, we got upcoming things.
We got Frostburg coming up. Okay.
We're going to New York soon, and when you get hot out, you know, in May, we'll be in New York.
Yeah. So y'all working on like some of the spring collection, and then you already dropped
exactly.
That's coming out soon.
Basically, it's already done. It's just getting done.
Are you the designer?
Yeah.
Okay.
I design everything.
You're the only sole designer for the company?
Yeah, and I give everybody give their input, you know what I'm saying? We feed off each other, but mainly I design the clothes.
Okay. So my question to you guys are like, all right, what's, we've been doing like a lot of interviews with people who own lines, clothing lines lately.
Yeah, shout out to Original Crack if they came through.
So like, are you guys actually making these clothes, or are you kind of just like design printing on clothes? Because a lot of people are getting into the route of clothing, I would say.
We started off straight cut and sew. Like, we in the, and I got a sewing machine, Singer, right in the basement, just cooking it up, you know what I mean? My grandma was a professional seamstress, so everything is just basically learned through her. And sometimes she even busts the clothes out, you know what I'm saying? I just pay her. But that's where it started off. Now we have a manufacturer that we use. So I basically just design everything, we send it off, and try to get it mass produced.
Mm-hmm.
But
One of the questions I never get to ask was, and I want to ask you, like, y'all are designing your clothes and it's picking up heavy. I got a lot of people out here in the DMV area that's rocking you again. Was you one of the people that was, like, best dressed in school? Or was this just, like, something you just decided to do and then people just started picking it up?
What's crazy is, in school, I used to, I know you probably remember the old Aja Amanis and shit, the hand paint shirts.
Mm-hmm.
I used to do that. Yeah, I used to do that in school from basically 8th grade to 12th grade, but just for like fun, side bread. Like I said, my grandma was a professional seamstress, so I was just always around that shit. Like, she was always just making stuff, and I was like, man, I knew how to draw a little bit, so I whipped something up, throw a little jean patch on the side of the clothes, something. And after that, I graduated high school, went to college. I went to school for IT at Tusk College. Dropped out, basically, because I was like, man, I like this, but it's not gaining my attention. I'm paying bread for something that I'm not passionate about, you know what I mean? So I can't get with it. So I was like, man.
So you dropped out of school, and you started designing the clothes, yeah. And you got with your crew, and y'all started doing it,
right.
To say the least.
To say the least, all in the whole.
So what's next, school, man? So you guys are doing music, you know, putting shows together. Like, what's your next feat, I would say, to take over the DMV, to make it national? Like, what, you know, changing designs? How will you want, you know, step it up from this point on?
Basically, I feel you gotta keep, you know, reinventing yourself over and over as far as the clothes and just being a person and all. But our next step is basically to expand the brand. Like, I love the area, but, you know, it's time to move out, go to touch different areas, different countries, you know what I'm saying? Really go and get inspiration from different cultures. But, like, I'm really there, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can fly to Dubai or China or some, you know what I mean, shit like that. And get just inspired just from the area and go straight into making some shit. So that's basically what we on.
Real fashion.
And yeah, and also like little events like giveaways and stuff for the youth and
community is big.
Yeah, community events.
Like, definitely rap about that.
Yeah. Because I even have like just cookouts, just cool people just coming out vibing. You know what I'm saying? Networking.
Lead the hate at home.
Yeah.
Inhale love.
Tell them again.
Exhale hate.
That's how slow. Inhale love. Exhale hate.
Embrace the hate.
So, see what we doing now. Love. We exhale the hate.
That's what's up.
Basically, yeah. That's the base of everything as far as the brand and how we just roll.
Okay. So, I remember I seen you post up on Instagram that you had the gear and Fallsville Mall, and then you turn around, you had it at the Boulevard. How did you feel about getting things like that? A lot of people just be making clothes, but they don't really make it to the stores. You know what I'm saying? So how did you feel when you got your clothes in the store?
When we first got in there, you know, I was happy and all excited, you know what I mean? But, you know, business ain't go right how it was, but it was a learning experience.
What, from the from Fallsville to the Boulevard? It wasn't selling?
No, I'll mostly say the Boulevard. I don't want to say from Fortisville, but from the Boulevard.
So it's still in there now?
No, I had to cut that.
Okay.
Both of them? Yeah. Both stores?
Yeah, I cut both of them, because that's around when we got our own boutique. Now,
where's your boutique?
We had one.
Okay.
Yeah. So now we just focus on online, and then we about to get some at Pentagon City Mall.
Okay.
So
okay.
We just keep moving, you know what I mean?
You feel like it's hard to just kind of get it in a mall and just sell from that point, you know? Like,
nah, the clothes speak for itself, so, you know what I mean, it's not really. Most of the time, if I go to somebody, how even
I mean, to get in the mall, actually, like, because a lot of people jump on this game of, I want a design, I make a cool design, and then I'm going to just put something on the t-shirt, and now I have a line, and I just change the color, and that's my line. And then they don't really make it anywhere else besides the Instagram post, the I'm coming to this show and trying to sell it. You actually have yours in the mall, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think it's all in how you approach it and what you bring to the table. I mean, you can't deny quality. So I think that more so it'll just speak for itself. I mean,
basically what he's saying is we show love, we support everybody chasing their dreams, and they, everybody know, you know if you're passionate about something or not, you're just doing this to go.
Yeah, right? Exactly.
You're doing it from your heart, you feel like it's your purpose, or you're just doing it to try it out, you know? This is passion, I know, you know what I'm saying? I knew since I was a young dude, you know what I'm saying? When everybody, where I'm from, we don't dress the same, you know what I mean? We from PG, but my neighborhood specifically, we don't all dress the same. I knew who was fly, I was fly since I was younger. And he seen how I was moving, type of person I am, and made me like, little bro, look, you can be a street team manager. You know, became brand ambassador. It's a little different, you know what I'm saying? Now,
yeah.
You know, we really be formulating stuff, you know what I'm saying? We used to really brainstorm in my house, my old house. We used to be in the basement smoking just like this.
That's what this about is. What we gonna do, you feel me? And then it came to fruition, you know what I'm saying? Since, but that was, it was moving before I came along, but when I got with it too, and the other people got with it too, I'm just saying like, wow, yeah, we expanding. And everybody putting their talent somewhere, and he orchestrated that, you know what I'm saying? So Live Love Culture is more than the clothing line. That's what I'm gonna tell you. It's more than the clothing line. And I'm gonna stand behind that.
Brotherhood.
You know, it's a brotherhood, it's a and it's unity. You know, for like he said, all races. I ain't trying to brag, but we got all type of models, Russian, Latino. Like, we don't.
Yeah, I've been to the shoot. Down, like, I definitely do that, man.
But you know, all glory to God. The one thing about it, we all believe in God too. You know, that's real.
Yeah,
you know?
Everything's by Him.
Mm-hmm. It's very smooth. Everything. So I don't know what everybody else's motivation is or their inspiration, but we know we got God in us. We ain't perfect, but you know, we living for a purpose. You know. How we feel.
My man, respect. You know what I'm saying? Respect. I definitely appreciate you fellas coming through and rocking with DMV The Basement, man. Yeah, it's, you know, it seems like y'all got a lot going on, and I look forward to seeing y'all out here at these festivals. And
this summer, I'm gonna
definitely
cop
me some beer, so I can blend in with the crew, you know.
Yeah.
All vibes.
For the people
here
who don't know, just, you know what I'm saying, let them know exactly where they can get some Live Love Culture gear real quick. They should know though, because y'all definitely out here. But just tell them one time.
You can shop online right now at liveloveculture.com. That's LIVLUV culture.com. Or hit us up by email, liveloveculture@gmail.com.
Or you can pull up at any one of our events because they support. They definitely be in the building. You know, and they always got some gear to let go. It's still blowing down.
I want
to
thank y'all for tuning in.
Now we tuning out.
Marico Million, Moezy, DMV The Basement, Live Love Culture.
Appreciate you. Appreciate you talking about.